Hello everyone, this is Sam from Datiku Studios. In this video, I want to talk about Crease in 3D Studio Max. First of all, I should mention that Crease system is not standard. What I mean by that? I mean all 3D applications or game engines does not support Crease system. For example, 3D Studio Max or Maya support that, but Unreal Engine and Unity, as I know, does not support Crease system. Alright, I make a cube and applying Turbo Smooth to this cube with 4 iteration. As you see, your box morph to some spherical smooth shape. If you want to keep your edges hard, the standard technique is collapse to editable poly and add support edges. Something like that. And now I could apply a Turbo Smooth modifier. This is standard technique and you could export this model to any other 3D applications, but usually takes too much time. Also, your segments will increase too. Another technique is, instead of adding support edges, you could select your edges. In the Edit Edges Edge property, you could increase your crease value. I enable Show End Result toggle on to see the final result. And now while my all edges selected, starting to increase crease value. It doesn't necessary to select all edges for sure. For example, I select 2 top edges of this box and reduce the crease value to 0. As you see, without adding any extra edge, we have very sharp corners in this model. For example, if I export this geometry by FBX format, and re-import that model, you see your result is totally different. So be aware, you cannot use this technique to export your models to all other applications. Some 3D applications support it and some others does not. Another way to use a crease, you could apply that as a modifier. So I made a cube again, going to modifier list and select the crease modifier. Also, I apply Turbo Smooth modifier. Go back to crease and go to the all edges and start to increase the value. I want to mention another tips here. If you apply Turbo Smooth modifier to geometry already set the crease, your corners will keep the angles and will be sharp. Instead, if you're using the open subdiv, your corners will be rounded, and usually this is more desirable method. I go edit poly again and set the crease value to 0, show the end result. You don't have to apply the crease to all edges for sure. For example, I could select only these 4 segments and start to increase the value. The value is between 0 to 1. I could select 4 other edges and start increasing the value. You cannot export this properly to other applications unless you collapse all the modifiers already applied. Third way to apply crease is using mesh smooth modifier. From modifier list, I select mesh smooth modifier. Increase iteration. Now in the local control sub object level, you could select edge. I select these 8 edges again. Now we have crease value here too. You can increase the value. As you see, your result is similar to Turbo Smooth. If you need rounded corners, you could apply Open Subdiv on the stack. Now you achieved more smooth results. However, we have more complicated way to apply crease too. For example, by angle or other conditional situations, like using data channel, which I described that in another video. Thanks for watching.